Hello students, I am continuing with few more explanation of article writing. Now the next one that I am about to discuss is related with the topic disaster management. So let me come to the question and then I will move on to the answer part. Our country is prone to disasters, natural disasters, or we talk about natural calamities, it is that, like floods, drought, cyclones, or earthquakes. Measures are adopted to cope with every disaster. The slow response results in loss of human lives and property. Write an article for a newspaper giving suggestions about disaster management. You may suggest having special equipment, trained personnel, better transport and communication, quick decisions and speedy implementation. Now these are the verbal input points. Write an article, and the word limit already you know by this time, it is 150 to 200 words. And name is given, either you are Shishir or Sweta. So I already told you all that the article is related with disaster management. So let's continue. Again, some important points only I will explain. Our country is prone to disasters like floods, drought, cyclones, or earthquakes. We do not have any clear-cut policy of disaster management, nor any force to tackle the situation. Now, we don't have any force to tackle the situation. Neither we have a very strong backup disaster management system also. We wait and watch for others to join the fray. Now, normally we wait and watch, and we want help from other countries also sometimes when disaster management is uncontrollable at that moment only. There are heated arguments over jurisdiction, state or central liability, official assessment and surveys before any help is rushed out to the affected area. Now, before any sort of help is given to the affected area, a lot of politics goes on. A lot of dirty politics goes on. Then only the entire procedure gets sanctioned, and then only helps goes out or reaches out to the affected area. Now, the slow response results in the loss of precious human lives and valuable property. Now, because of this slow response, or because of taking decisions without implementing it at the right time, many lives are lost, and along with some valuable property also. We must have clear-cut, well-defined guidelines for disaster management. We have to be more professional. We have to be more responsible. And last but not the least, we should have a very clear-cut, well-defined guidelines for disaster management. A well-trained task force having special equipment and trained personnel should be constituted. A well-planned, I already told you, professional task force must be created. Otherwise, very difficult to tackle with natural calamities, or very difficult to tackle when there is any disaster. So I repeat, a well-trained task force having special equipment and trained personnel should be constituted. Its controlling officer should have the authority to take decisions and ensure their speedy implementations. Now, the controlling officer should take the initiative and ensure speedy implementation. Better transport and communication facilities will ensure better results. If the transport and communication facilities are upgraded, then obviously the rescue process will be much more faster, and communication also will be faster. Bureaucratic setup should not be allowed to interfere with the work of the disaster management group. Now, bureaucratic setup, it should not interfere with the workings of the disaster management group, then again politics will come and the entire situation will be ruined. So the disaster management group, the authority in charge of the disaster management group, should come forward and should implement the procedure successfully. Now, dear students, I am moving on to one more article writing question, and it is related with hypocrisy. Now, before I go to explain, I explain you the answer, I like to explain the question before that. Hypocrisy exists in abundant measure in our society. People do not practice what they preach. They have double standards, or rather to say, double mentality. They are rude and dishonest, but expect politeness and honesty from others. They are themselves double standard, they have double standard mentality, but they expect others to be polite and honest. There are numerous examples of lack of sincerity in our daily experience. Now, this article is related to that. That is hypocrisy or double standards or double mentality people. Read an article, word limit, you know by this time, 150 to 200 words, showing how such behavior causes disharmony at home, in the neighborhood, and at the workplace. And you are either Harshit or Harsha. Now, hypocrisy. My neighbor shows great concern for the poor, but beats his 14-year-old servant black and blue. Now, what sort of a mentality my neighbor has? Double standard mentality. He is generous towards the poor, but he himself beats his servant, his housekeeper, whenever the housekeeper does some mistake. Mr. Seth, the rich man living in that palatial house. Palatial is something related with a castle, big house like a palace. Expects the government to do everything for him, but he himself evades paying taxes. He lives in a big palatial house. He's a rich man. He wants the government to do everything for the betterment of the masses, but he himself doesn't pay any taxes. The pious old woman upstairs feeds the sacred cow, the ants and the birds, but is merciless to her neighbor's pet dog and kicks shoes away and beats the poor pup whenever it strays over to her path. Now, another double standard mentality example has been given. The pious old woman, she moves upstairs, feeds the sacred cow, the ants and the birds, but she is very harsh when it comes to the neighboring dogs and other animals. She is very harsh on those things. Thus, in small matters and big ones, we find people lacking sincerity in their dealings with others. Now, whether it's a small issue, petty one, or it's a big matter, we find that people are practicing double mentality. There is a difference in their way in which they deal with others. The consequences of such hypocritical and discriminatory behavior are quite damaging and harmful. Now, the consequence of such hypocritical and discriminatory behavior are quite damaging and it is harmful. This causes a breach in the family. This ultimately causes a difference in the family, a discord in the family. Love is lost between brothers and family ties are weakened. Love is lost. Family ties are also weakened. Our neighbors begin to lose faith in us. It creates misunderstanding among the neighbors because of few neighbors who are hypocrites, who have a double standard mentality. Suspicion and selfishness replace trust and dedicated service. Now, this is a very, very important line. I like to explain this. Suspicion and selfishness, if it grows inside us, then obviously it replaces trust and dedicated service. Thus, good neighborliness is broken. A bond among the neighbors, if suspicion and selfishness starts breeding or starts growing, then obviously good neighborly relationships or neighborliness is broken, and community living is vitiated by the virus of hypocrisy. Vitiated means it is totally polluted, and a communal harmony, number one, then communal feelings and a good emotional bonding, everything gets totally vitiated by the virus of hypocrisy. So it should be checked. In workplace too, dishonesty and community living is in workplace too, dishonesty can bring ruin to the flourishing business. Now, in workplace also, if few people are dishonest, then ultimately the work sector gets polluted. So I repeat, in workplace too, dishonesty can bring ruin to the flourishing business. Hence, people should control their selfishness and be truthful in their dealings. So what we should do? What should be our motto? Our motto should be that we should control this sort of dual standard mentality. We should not practice this double standard mentality. We should not be a hypocrite. We should not be selfish. But what we should be? We should be honest and we should be truthful in our dealings. Then only we can save our community. Otherwise, the virus of hypocrisy will spread and it might pollute the communal well-being among the people. So that was the explanation related with this article. Dear students, in this audio presentation also I discussed two important topics. One is hypocrisy and the other one was disaster management. Go through these two. And in some of my other videos later also, I will discuss few more articles with you all. Thank you, students.